May I start on the topic on the sharing my experience on the COVID-19 clinical case management. For more detail of the slide, we could give to you in the later after the presentation. Next slide, please. This is the virus. The virus that we call them as the SARS-CoV-2. This virus that, as everyone know, that is like the have the two layer. The first one is on the outside is lipid membrane, and also in the side they are the RNA virus. This is the envelope virus. So the important thing that we have is the for the envelope virus, it's easy to hide. If they have the problem on the anything on the RNA on that one, the next slide, please. Next slide, please. Yes, thank you. This is a 2019 novel coronavirus name. So as we know that the virus is the name of the SARS-CoV-2. SARS stands for severe acute respiratory syndrome. COVID-2 is a coronavirus 2. But the disease name, as the World Health Organization gave the name, is the COVID-19. Corona, VI is virus, D is disease, and 19 is 2019. Yes. Next slide, please. From this one, the important thing that, as we know that, usually for the transmission of the respiratory disease, we have the airborne and also the droplet. This picture is really important that Thailand using to tell our population that for the airborne, this means that even though we stay far away, maybe 5 meters, 20 meters, something like that, it could go very easily for because the droplet is really small. This one mostly are the tuberculosis, measles, and also other the virus that really small one. For the droplet, it's mostly have the droplet is a bigger particle, so it mostly will drop very near with the patient. They are the mostly are the SARS-CoV, influenza, and also the avian flu, including the other for the, this one coronavirus. So this one, what we want to tell the our populate our type our people that if they are stay in the very close space, for example, in the nightclub or bar, anything that, or in the bus, in the small bus, it could be changed from the droplet to become the aerosol because it's the really in the close space. Next slide, please. Yes, for the incubation period of the coronavirus is a vary from 2 days to 14 days. It depends on the maximum of the virus that the people get. So this one we also tell the people that if they have the fever or they have the any symptom that we will discuss later in that one, it will be have the people infected. Yes, next slide, please. For the signs and symptoms of COVID-19, this one that most of us that we have the problem is a cough, which mostly more than 60%. Fever, and the fever is very, if they have the not severe case, the fever, it might be really, really low, 37.5 Celsius. But if they have the involved to the lung, the fever, it might quite high. It may could be the 38.5 or 39 Celsius degree that we found with the patient. If the more high fever is demand the lung and also the cytokine that have the problem. Sore throat we found, and also we have the more than that, I'm sorry, this in Thai, but it's similar to this one that they don't have the, in the beginning that in Thailand, we have the three phase. The first phase is that the mostly the people have the, with the, come with the sore throat and some fever. But for the this period, we have three wave, right? The first wave last year, second wave during the New Year's at the end of December and April that we have, we call the third wave. The third wave is a more have the symptom of the no smell, the taste less taste. They cannot taste that how the food tastes. So this one, and also we found with them have the diarrhea and also the latch that in the last year that we not found. And some the virologists said that because the genotype is different. Last year that the genotype that we had is from the Asia, from China and from the in our area. But this year is the chain form we call the genome that we found is the B1.1.7. If you this one is mostly we call the India type for the genome type for this one, and they have more severe than the other genome. Next slide, please. Yes, next slide, please. This slide want to show that if the patient they have cough, 90% that the person who stay near could have the infected more than 90%. But if the healthy person wear mask, even though the patient cough or sneezing, the droplet will less the risk from 90% to 30%. Another thing, if the patient wear mask, even though they cough, or even though the healthy person not wear the mask, the risk is reduced to 5%. In addition, if both of the patient and healthy person wear mask, the risk of infected will be 1.5%. And if they stay distancing more than 1 meter or 1.5 meter, this means that both of them, the healthy person will have the low risk. So this picture is very important that we give to the all medias in Thailand, even though the television, the Facebook, or another thing that to let the people to understand that everyone need to wear mask. Otherwise it will be infected, even though stay in the same family, because it will have the, from the droplet could be infected on that one. Next slide, please. The coronavirus is very important that they fast to spreading because of what? They say that from one person to two person, from two to, and it means that like the exponential growth. So this very important that when we about the patient, if we can, it will have the problem with the easy to have the epidemic in the small community on that one. Yes, next slide, please. So from this one, this picture, the source from the World Health Organization and CDC, the symptoms of COVID-19 and influenza that they have the dry cough when compared with COVID-19. Influenza, the second column, and common cold. We can find that for the COVID-19, mostly they have a fever and dry cough. But this one in general population, however, in the elderly or in the chronic disease, some person, they don't have the high fever. They just have the drowsiness and then they feel that they feel not uncomfortable. Compared with the influenza, most of the influenza heavily high fever if they have the complication from the influenza. And for the cold, less fever. Compared with the headache and body ache, influenza more than COVID-19. And the last one is the diarrhea. COVID-19 in this outbreak that we have during the April to up to now, we found that most of the patients have diarrhea. They could come with the softening diarrhea or watery diarrhea for the patient that we found. Okay, next slide, please. This is the global situation. The global situation we got from the World Health Organization, we found that this is the very big pandemic when compared with other epidemic in the world. because for the confirmed case, more than 160 million have infected. And today you can see at the below plus, more than 600,000 that have infected for the COVID-19. For today, more than 106,000 cases recover less than that one. Can you see? It's blue. For the death, more than 3 million. Okay. When comparing the ranking, this one just copy for the 20 higher ranking. The most important is the United States, India, and Brazil. Thailand is 99 ranking. We have more than 88,000 that have the infected. And now we face with the dead cases. Most of the cases that we work, I will show you the slide later. Now, for the Peru, this is the Peru. Now, Peru is 1.8 million that have confirmed cases. Yes. Next slide, please. This is in the Asia. So we compare in the Asia that we found that in Thailand that we have the cases, the 88 million for this one. In our Southeast Asia, that for the color, you can see that if the red one is mean more than 50,000 cases. And also the last one is in the, this Laos, Cambodia, this is a Thailand map. And also from the data from this one, for the epidemiological data, we found that most of the dead cases, if we have the dead, we found that most of them, the age of the dead among the more than 50 years old and up to the 90 years old. And most of them now, they have the underlying disease with the diabetes, uncontrolled diabetes, obesity. For the obesity in the case that death we from analysis, more than 30, BMI more than 30. So this one make us really concerned that for the among the death cases that we need to work with them on that one. For the next slide, I will show you for the how we work with them. Next slide, please. From that one that we, from the data we analyzed and catering, we found that when compared with the severity of the symptom of COVID-19, we divided in four groups. The first group is confirmed case asymptomatic. This one, this group, we found about 60% of the cases. Second, confirmed case with mild symptom. What does it mean of mild symptom? For example, have fever or cough, but no pneumonia. This one, we call them the mild symptom. It might have the diarrhea or smelling, cannot smell, something like that. So this one we found, this group we found about the 15 to 25%. The third group, confirmed case with mild symptoms, with risk factor. The risk factor that we have the list is, the first one is age more than 16 years old. Other chronic disease, chronic kidney disease. Now we're getting more cases of chronic kidney disease. The fourth one is cardiovascular disease, including the congenital heart disease, cerebrovascular disease, uncontrolled DM. This is a very most common for it can cause the become to the very severe. And obesity, sorry, it's in China. For the obesity, the BMI more than that, we found the more than 90 kilo or more than or equal to 35 kilo, but now we reduce from 35 to 30 because some people, some cases that about the 32 for the BMI, about 32 per kilo per square meter for the cirrhosis and also for the low immune cases. For this one that we have the combat with them, that for the confirmed case with my symptom and factor, most of them that have mostly come with the mild pneumonia. And the fourth group is really a severe case that we call them confirmed case with pneumonia. But however, when the patient come with the pneumonia and have the oxygen saturation at room air, for the detail, we if we have time, I will share you with the X-ray. Because if you found the X-ray, that you could say that, oh, this is most likely the COVID-19 cases. Next slide, please. From that, we review. This one actually in the first half problem that we found that this is the virus when you come to the cell. We have many antiviral that could combat in each one. Last year that we have, we thought that chloroquine that inhibit the virus come to cell, lopinavir and ritonavir also inhibit the proteinase, and also the favipiravir also that inhibit for the RNA polymerase. And the last one is the steroid on that. But however, from this, in the beginning of the first batch of the our case management, we use that combination, chloroquine, lopinavir, ritonavir, which usually is an anti-HIV treating the AIDS patient, and also the favipiravir. After that, from the, we found that we have problem with the chloroquine, because chloroquine can make the patient have the cardiac arrest. So for this one, we stop to using that one. What we use now, next slide, please. From the data, we found that hydroxychloroquine, azithromycin, in May in Thailand, that we found that we heard from the article that azithromycin could help the patient with hydroxychloroquine, so we give the patient. However, after that, we found patient could develop cardiac arrest because they have the QT prolonged. So the thing that we stop no more use for the hydroxychloroquine and azithromycin anymore with the patient with the COVID-19. Next slide, please. We got the medication from China and Russia, and we found that from the study, we bought the favipiravir in the beginning. We found that favipiravir in China and Russia have more effective in early stage among the COVID-19 cases, that we found that this one, the cases, and it really helpful for now. So that we could say that favipiravir is the lighted drug of choice in Thailand for the COVID-19. That we using for the patient, but it's not the single drug use. Now we use the combination. Next slide, please. You might heard about the patient with COVID-19. Most of them that have the immune response, or we call them as the cytokine storm. So some physicians said that they want to use the interleukin 6, tocilizumab. And from the article, many article, and also in Thailand experience, we found that tocilizumab in the hospital patient with severe COVID. When they study, they have many study, they found that this is a multiple clinical trial study. They found multi-center clinical trial, they found that this is a tocilizumab. This is a possible. They found that tocilizumab and possible are not the have not the real impact to help the severe cases. So the next slide, please. So in conclusion, that we formed the many article and that one in the up till the last year, that in October 2020, we still have the four group: confirmed case asymptomatic, confirmed case with mild symptoms, confirmed case with symptomatic, with symptom, with risk factor, and no pneumonia. And the confirmed case with pneumonia. And we recommend, the Thai national guidelines suggest that recommend based on the limited evidence, need more update clinical study. So when we have the outbreak again in the December, we're still using. And up to now, for this month, we just have revised the guideline. Next slide, please. The most update guideline is on May 6, just last week. We found that for the asymptomatic cases, no need for the specific treatment. if they have the just malice, just let them the forgive the mean or something like that. Because we found that if we give the antiviral in the asymptomatic group, they might have the side effect from the antiviral. The side effect that we talk about in the detail later. So we told the 60% that have asymptomatic, we did not give any medication. For the second group, confirmed case with mild symptom, we give them symptomatic treatment and antiviral is depend on what they have. For example, we will give them favipiravir for the 5 days. For the dose, I will tell you the detail later. Nah. For the third group, confirmed case with mild symptom, with leaf factor, it might have some pneumonia or not some pneumonia. We say that if the confirmed case that you could remember, uncontrolled DM, chronic disease, coronary heart disease and whatever and something, or obesity, we will give them as soon as possible with the favipiravir. From our study, from the 744 cases, we found that the early favipiravir or antiviral that we give them, it helped them to recovery, not go to become to the pneumonia or severe cases. But however, some case had the severe, developed the severe. The severe, what does mean? They mean that pneumonia progressive rapidly within 48 hours. And also for the oxygen sat less than 96%, we said that they are the severe case. So we give them the corticosteroid. Also from the recommend from the World Health Organization, recommend the only one drug is corticosteroid. So we give combination with favipiravir and corticosteroid among the who develop the severe case, especially in the chronic cases. The last group, confirmed case with pneumonia, oxygen sat at room air less than 96%. We have two choice to diagnose for the case. The first one is the oxygen sat at room air if less than 95%, or we call exercise-induced hypoxemia. For example, we let them walk around the bed that during the examination, just one round. If they feel that tired and oxygen sat drop more than 93%, for example, when we measure them at our OPD, their oxygen sat about 96. When they walk around the bed, the patient bed, one round, the oxygen sat dropped to 93%. This means that it's a really important for that it might have the hypoxemia. And this group, we found that we give them the favipiravir plus lopinavir and ritonavir. This one, the antiviral, we found that the lopinavir, ritonavir could reduce the duration of the patient who have the developed the severe, reduce the duration in ICU from 11 days to 6 days. So we give them in this group. But however, lopinavir and also ritonavir, they have the side effect of the medication. The side effect of them that mostly found the nausea and also the some diarrhea on that. In addition, we also give them the corticosteroid in the severe case. But if the for the critical care, I not talk today, nah. If we want to learn more, we will share experience later on that. But I just give the information about that we have in the in general on this one. However, all this regimen that we talk is based on the limited evidence, and we need more update clinical study in the future. And now in Thailand, we have many cases. The thing that many we set up the clinical study and also the clinical trial in the many group that maybe in the next future, more than 3 more months, we could share experience with the Peru again on our study on that one. Next slide, please. This is the favipiravir that we have. The tablet amount, the 20 milligram, I did not sell the medication. I just tell that what we have in Thailand. Next slide, please. The favipiravir that we gave the patient is the, we gave the dose set, there's a 9 tablet because 200 milligram. This one we gave them 9 tablet twice a day in the first day, and following we gave 5 days for the not severe case. If the severe case, we could extend until the 10 day. But the BMI is very important. More, for example, more than 90 kilo, we will increase the dose. But however, we need to adjust among the liver patients that have the problem on that one. In the children, it depends on the dose they have. Next slide, please. The precaution of favipiravir that we have, it could cause the teratogenic effect. In Japan, they, even though Japan is the country that who developed favipiravir, they not use in the Japan. Only China, Russia, and Thailand. Because they say that it could cause the teratogenic effect. So we aware, tell the clinician aware that if they want to give the to the pregnant women, now we use another medication we call the remdesivir to the patient. But however, we need to, it might cause the possible production of the red cell and liver function. So if we give the favipiravir, we have to monitor for the liver function test of the patient on that. And we also tell the all clinicians in Thailand need to report adverse drug reaction and other side effects to the DMSMin Department of Medical Services and also the FDA in Thailand. Next slide, please. Other consideration, the using favipiravir, as I told in the beginning, that in pregnant women may cause teratogenic effect. So need the recommendation to discuss with among the patient and physician. However, the patient who received the darunavir, alitonavir, or lopinavir, alitonavir, this one in Thailand, we could produce our medication, need to consider to anti-HIV testing before prescribe this drug, because it might cause the diarrhea, nausea, vomiting, and also liver inflammation, including the drug infection. And for this one, that it might cause the QT prolonged. So this one is very important that when the patient admit and before we give the medication, we need to do the EKG. And following, if they give more than 5 days, we have to repeat the EKG again. Next slide, please. After the patient, we have the 4 levels of our healthcare system. We call the primary care, secondary care, tertiary care, and super tertiary care. Most of the cases, if they have asymptomatic, they could admit in all level of primary care, secondary, tertiary, and super tertiary. But if the patient have condition, we tell our doctor that if a patient is in a condition beyond the healthcare facility, what does it mean? Mean that the oxygen sat in at room air less than 96%, rapid progressive pneumonia within 48 hours, need to refer. So if the primary care cannot handle, they have to refer to the secondary care. And if secondary care cannot, they have to refer to the upper, the tertiary care. This means that it's very important that we set up the referral system and transfer system at the early stage before the intubation. Because if the patient, COVID-19 patient intubate, it's very difficult to refer. So we suggest that please refer as soon as possible before intubation. So we give the 96%. This one, if you review for the WHO, WHO give that oxygen sat at room air need to less than 92%. And NIH suggests that saturation, oxygen sat need to less than 94%. But in Thailand that we have difficult for the transfer or refer. It might take 1 or 2 hours. The longest one may be 6 hours of the patient. So we suggest that early transfer cases or early refer cases as soon as possible if the oxygen sat less than 96% to save the patient to have to go to the better or more higher capacity of healthcare facility. Next slide, please. And after the patient, they develop better the criteria to discharge the patient. The patient whose symptoms improve and whose beam X-ray does not show decline condition or any problem, so we califer. And in the second, body temperature not exceed than this means that they don't have fever at least 24 hours. The third one, respiratory rate no more than 20 times per minute, and also oxygen sat at room air more than 96. If the patient have four of the list one, we allow them to discharge the patient. And we also have the, we call you might heard the hospital or field hospital. The next, after we finish that, we will discuss on that. Patients who test positive do not need to repeat the swab, because we believe that the patient who repeat the swab, it might have the problem during the beginning of the, the beginning of the COVID-19, we let the patient that need to be swab on that. But now we don't have on that one. Okay. Ivermectin for the inhalant. Okay. Let me finish it and I will answer all your question that we discussed. After discharge, if any symptom occur, consider the identifying the cause of the treatment, because we have the patient after they stay in the hospital 14 days. It depends 14 or 1 month. It depends on the severity. After they discharge, some patient have the fever again and they come back. We found that it might have another pneumonia. When we treating, we found that they might have the pneumonia from the bacterial infection or other cause. So we need to identify cause and provide treatment accordingly that they have the cause. Next slide, please. So the key of our case management: early detection, early diagnosis, early treatment, and early containment. It's really helpful for us that to combat with the COVID-19 cases. Next slide, please. I will show you the chair experience that when the patient come a lot, the thing that is really important for us is helpline. What does it mean, helpline? Helpline, that mean the patient could call, because when the pandemic come, some hospital reduce the patient, reduce the work activity. So we just use the call, okay, you no need to come to our hospital. We also have the business continuity plan for the each hospital that they need to plan that if they have overwhelming of the patient, what they have to do, because we did not treat only the COVID-19 patient, but we treat all patients that we have. For example, pregnant lady, chronic cases, or the diabetes cases in the normal day that they have the COVID-19. So the important thing that we need to help them on that. After they call, for example, the patient who come with the chronic, the usually they will come to the patient every month to see the patient, to see the doctor, diabetes. The pharmacist is really helpful for us. They help the delivery, the medication. I think we have the pharmacy with us in our group here. Next slide, please. And also this one called new normal medical services. So when the patient come to our hospital, this one picture we call have the fever clinic, fever and acute respiratory clinic. This one is from the nursing hospital in the nearby the Siloam complex. So the thing that done with the patient come, okay, you stay here, you waiting until we give you, the nurse will give them what you have fever, you see the measure the fever, okay, tell the doctor that you have anything what. And this one, they like the screening. This one, they're waiting for to screen, and then they will go to see the doctor after go to this stair. Next slide, please. This one, we call patient under investigation clinic. We have many clinic on that one to make sure that the patient, they have the come to directly. This one, they have the waiting because they are tired and they cannot walk something. When they come to the PI clinic, when they come to the waiting, they will have the nurse. The nurse will screening, and after that checking, okay, you need to your PI. We have four definition. This one, our case management work with really closely with the division of epidemiology, which most of them have the field epidemiology training program that have the doctor that work together. Okay, if your definition match with the patient under investigation, for example, you have fever, you have the cough, and you come with the hospital with the have history contact with the COVID-19 cases. Okay. Or the second, you are the healthcare worker and have contact with the COVID-19 without the appropriate PPE. You may need to come to the high risk group. Or the third one, that if they have the cluster in the school, cluster among the healthcare worker, a cluster in the office, more than 5 cases, we need, they will match with the PUI clinic. Patient under investigation unit, they will come to the hospital and they will check, the nurse will check, okay, you are matched with this, you need to do the swab. And the diagnosis for the confirmed cases is we using the RT-PCR. We not, we using the RT-PCR as the confirmed cases for COVID-19. If are positive, all of the cases need to admit in hospital. Now we have problem that the hospital have not enough bed. The thing that we do, we cooperate with the hotel. We call them hospital plus hotel. We call them as hospital. Hospital. The patient that have infected and they don't have any symptom, they will go to the hospital. They go to the hospital, I mean in the hotel, and we have the doctor to take care of them at that one. If they become, we will measure every day for the oxygen set in the morning and vital sign. And in the evening, also oxygen set and also the vital sign. If they have any fever or problem more, we will take them from the hospital to the hospital. So we will keep the hospital to take care for the patient who have the more problem rather than asymptomatic cases. Next slide, please. This one, as I told in the beginning, that not only the COVID-19, but we also have the other cases. For example, INT or other disease that to the hospital, we also need the triage, call them triage area. So if the patient who have come with the respiratory symptom, go to the AI clinic, go to the PUI clinic. If they don't have any respiratory symptom, come to here, we call triage area, OPD cases. This the nurse will check, okay, you come to here. So we want to less the crowded of the cases among the other. Next slide, please. Okay. Thank you. That's all for the in the experience on this one to sharing. We will answer for the question now. Okay, stopping for sharing the slide, please. Thank you. So I think we have many questions. May I go to the question or what we have to do, or we will next step, please.
Sí, claro. De ser posible que conteste la doctora, puede ir a...
Yes, doctor, please. You can proceed to answer the questions if you'd like.
Okay.
You can...
I will go to the question. Some question is the Spanish. I cannot read. I can read only the English.
Ay. Muy bien.
Would it be possible for Mr. Rafael to
¿Sería posible que Rafael o alguien lea la pregunta?
To translate some of the questions for
algunas
us.
De las que traduzca alguna de las preguntas, por favor.
Hello.
Yes.
Morning. This is Ada Pastor from ENSAP.
Hi, doctor. I'm Karen from ENSAP. The participants are interested in knowing about ivermectin. Have you used ivermectin in...
Okay, ivermectin, you mean ivermectin for the treatment, right? Okay, ivermectin, we just have the, we have the study, clinical trial. We have the success that the ivermectin in the laboratory, they stop COVID-19 to replication, but not in the clinical trial yet. So, we have the, we call in the Mahidol University to study on that. And the professor present to us. However, we plan, let them to, they said that they need to study in the clinical trial before we using in the human. So we not using ivermectin in our patient right now. We need to waiting for the clinical trial first.
About azithromycin too. Azithromycin.
What about azithromycin?
Azithromycin. Okay. For azithromycin, that as in the slide, I show you that in the beginning last year, in the first wave of the, I think in the March and April, we using azithromycin because we got the article from the Eastern that said that azithromycin could help. But after we using and many studies show that azithromycin could make the patient have the QT prolonged and also doesn't have any impact to the coronavirus. They have harmful more than the useful. So we stop and we take the azithromycin out from our national guideline since the May last year. So no more, not using azithromycin.
Okay. Another question about what the population is thinks about.
The next the question is also in Spanish, would it be possible COVID-19
and
if or otherwise, this, I can go for the the English.
Yes,
one.
Of course.
So we have the question about ivermectin as well. So that has been answered already, right, Dr. Narumon?
We have no more using the azithromycin in COVID cases, except if they have bacterial infection from the culture or from the laboratory. For example, they have the COVID-19, but they have the bacteria on top. That one you will give them, but not azithro, we give other antibiotic instead.
Right, okay. So how about, how is an out-gestion of medical pills? Are they volunteers or do they have like medical staff? So this question is basically about the hospital. Dr. Narumon, can you explain about the operation, whether they used volunteers or full-time medical staff, please?
Okay, yes. This one is very important because during the, when we have the COVID-19, the government said that we have to semi-lockdown. The important after semi-lockdown that you cannot move from this province to another province. So the problem that the hotel, they have the, right, the bankrupt, something like that. So the thing that the government said that, okay, we have many space because hospital, when we have overwhelming, we don't have enough space for the patient. Our case management said that we want to reduce transmission among the cases. If one patient have the positive, the team epidemiologist, we call them SRT team, surveillance rapid response team, they will go to do the active case finding. And one from one case, we might find that contact case finding or active case finding more than 50 cases or something like that. And positive, we need to put the case, even though they have any symptom, to the hospital. If we don't have any hospital, hotel, or field hospital, we have developed this. Yeah, we have both hospital, field hospital, and also hotel. Hotel, we call them hospital, mean hotel plus hospital. We also have the doctor to take care of them, but we did not allow ward like in the hospital, but we monitor them where the water monitor. We call television, right? Job monitor, whatever. The television, something like that. We can see them. And if they have the problem, we will communicate with them with the line or with the other media that they will can talk. Zoom, we can use Zoom with the patient. We can see the patient, how are you today?
Puede ver al paciente cómo están hoy día. Se les da la medición de saturación de oxígeno a toda sala.
Bed. For now, we put them 2 person in 1 room if they are the COVID-19, nah? Yes.
And do you have like volunteers as well, like Asa Samak, volunteers working in hospital?
Yes, we have, but we did not let them to go to the room, the patient room, using the robot. We call Pinto. Pinto is mean of the name of the engineering they said from Chulalongkorn University. When we give the patient to the, for example, to the medication, we did not face to face with the patient by directly, but we see them by the by the media, something, or by the Zoom or something like that, to reduce the contact from the our healthcare worker. But they could contact with us 24 hours if they have any problem. And if they get said that they are not comfortable, they feel really bad for their breathing or something, that we will wear the PPE, full PPE, and they go to their room and we examination. If they are worse, we take them directly to the hospital.
Yeah, I understand that we use a lot of, you know, like communication application like LINE and WhatsApp as well to communicate with staff.
Uh-huh. Yes.
So the next question is whether Thailand is using enoxaparin as a preventive treatment in the care of COVID patients at the first level care.
Not really. We say it again. What is the name?
Enoxaparin.
Enoxaparin.
No, we not use that one because we believe that the most important thing to prevent the patient, for the healthy patient, is wear mask, because we call the distancing. Mask.
There's another
everyone need to wear mask. Either the cloth mask.
Do you have on the frequencies of hospital infections?
Yes, we do. The hospital infection, I think we have the next slide, but however, for the infection control, in each hospital, we have the infection control committee. Every hospital, they, even though they don't have the infectious doctor ID, but most of hospital, all hospital have ICN. ICN is the key person to help the our team. Actually, not only COVID that we start. We start for the infection control and how to prepare our hospital since the 20, I mean, maybe more than 15 years ago, since the avian flu. Avian influenza, that we have the problem in the 15 years ago. After that, we have the MERS COVID. Because in Thailand have many Muslim that they visit to the Middle East and they come. So at that time in the Middle East, they have the MERS COVID. So we prepare them, everyone have to concern on that. And in the 2009, we faced with the pandemic flu. So pandemic flu let us really alert on that. And also I think maybe because of this one, the ICN, the clinician, and also our healthcare worker, not only the in hospital, nah, we have the village health volunteer. I think in Thailand, our village, in Thailand from the country, we have the region. From region, we have 77 province. In each province, we have district. And in each district, we have sub-district. In each sub-district, we have the village. In village, we have the village health volunteer. They, in the beginning, they did not get any budget, but they work with their heart. They call them that health volunteer because they knock the door. Since the avian flu, they will saw that who have the fever for the COVID or for the avian, for the pandemic flu. 2009, they also help us to working on that. For this one, COVID-19, they also help us to combat with the, because we during the lockdown, some people want to go home. And when they go home, they have to report to their leader. The village health volunteer will knock their door. Hello, how are you today? Where are you from? You have fever? If you have fever, tell us. We will take care of you. and village volunteer will following them every until the 14 days, because the government said that we need to following the patient at least 14 days. This means that as the timeline of the COVID-19. Yes.
So, the next question. There's another question about how they handle.
So there's. Okay.
So do you have any experience using nebulized ivermectin in mild patients?
Elena.
It's an ivermectin in mild patients. ค่ะ คนไข้ที่แบบไม่รุนแรงมากอ่ะค่ะอาจารย
์ No, ivermectin non in the our clinical practice guideline. International clinical practice guideline have only favipiravir, corticosteroid and lopinavir. All three medication for the most update นะ. Ivermectin, we say that if the doctor want to use, you are responsibility. เป็นความผิดเขารับผิดชอบภาษาอังกฤษเร็ว
Sorry. That is responsibility if something happens. So it's like for the Thai clinical practice guideline, we only recommend those specific medications, right? So if they use other medication, it's not responsible by their medical doctors. It's not recommended, นะคะ so the next question is from Miss Helen. A person recover from COVID-19 until this, the person recover from COVID-19, can the disease still, you know, be able to spread? ยังกระจายได้ไหมถ้าคนหายแล้วอะค่ะอาจารย
์ Okay, from this one, very good question. We also have this problem because of what? Usually for the COVID-19, if the patient from the study from the virologist in Thailand, they said that actually I did not show you the slide. That slide, they have the study. I'm not sure I can find for you or not. The study showed if the patient have the symptom during the 14 day, they have many study. I will show you later. Nah, the study that they do the viral culture. We found that the viral culture from the stool culture, from the respiratory tract culture, for example, sputum or throat swab culture, we found that the day 8 of the patient, not the culture of the viral no more. So this means that even though we in some guideline, we said that we need to admit the patient for 14 days. But in some area, for example, if they have the problem, no more bed, we let them stay for 10 days. We believe from the study, we believe that after 10 days, even though the RT-PCR positive, but the viral culture don't have the viral viable. So to answer your question that, is it could transmit or not if the patient already go home? From the answer, if they could have, they did not transmit, but they could reinfect, because in the global now, we have many genotype of the COVID-19. In Thailand, we have at least 4 genome. The first one, Asian. Second, India. India, they have 2. B1.1.7. Second, B1.6.7. And also, we heard that they have African. I think maybe you have the Brazil type, something like that. It depends on that one. So to answer your question, if the patient have already infected and admit in the hospital and they treat, they are okay and happy. The doctor said that, okay, you go home from the discharge criteria. When they go home, they did not spread to other, but however, to make sure you might get under new type, so we suggest that you need to wear mask. We call them this one new normal lifestyle. In Thailand, say that even though you are not COVID or you are COVID-19 already treated, you need to wear masks, and you also need to do the distancing with other people. Even though you are in the same home, should wear masks because we are don't know, we are not sure that what kind of COVID-19 genotype that you will get.
So hay otras preguntas por ahí. Hay otras preguntas que están haciendo sobre
so la.
There's some other questions on reinfection.
¿Qué tan frecuente es la, ha sido no, los casos
another de question is how frequent has reinfection been in Thailand?
Reinfection. From the study, we don't have reinfection yet. After we, for example, Mr. A have admitted with the COVID-19. They go home. Oh, okay, they are happy, go home. After that, 1 month later, they have fever, come back with another pneumonia. So from this one, we, most of them, we found that they have the bacterial infection or influenza, not COVID. So from our report that we don't have, we don't find because we repeat RT-PCR and also repeat for the culture again. We don't have report for the reinfection yet, not yet. We hope not.
We also have question about the post-COVID.
Okay. También hay dos preguntas. Sí, hay dos preguntas. Like una que está referido
already, and sometimes they have back pain or chest pain. What is the treatment for that, Ka Ajahn?
From the study, I think many study in not Thailand yet, but from the in Europe or in America and in Japan study found that after the patient have infected, most of the viral left alveoli in the lung. They destroy the lung. Not only the viral, but also the cytokine. The cytokine is depend on each person response. We found that the most response of the cytokine of we will check from the blood CRP. We found that the very high CRP, this means that the very high cytokine response from the body. And when they destroy lung, it will become ARDS. But when they, if the patient have the ARDS and they recovery, full recovery, come back, the lung that they have destroyed is have take time to recover. Do I answer on that?
Yeah. So next Dr. Manuel. Okay. What has been the experience with hospitals, number of beds, equipment, what other type of patients were treated in hospitals ค่ะคือคนไข้ที่เข้าไปอยู่ใน hospital คือเป็นคนไข้ประเภทไหนแล้วก็มีจำนวนเตียงนะคะแล้วก็เครื่องมือในการรับรองรับแค่ไหนยังไงอาจารย
์เดี๋ยวหมอลองหาแป๊บหนึ่งหมอลองหาสไลด์เนาะโอเค answer during this one I might find the slide and share with you for thehospital, I will try to find on that one because it might be in Thai, but it will helpful for you on hospital on that. For the hospital on this one, during answer, I will find my slide. Nah. For the hospital of the cases that most of the cases come to the hospital that the patient, the doctor will say that you have to be age less than 60 year old.If you have the chronic disease, your chronic disease need to control. For example, diabetes, your diabetes need to be controlled, not the uncontrolled. If otherwise, you will be have the problem on that. The third one, some case we need to X-ray for now. All the cases we need to X-ray. If X-ray, the chest have problem,you go to the hospital, no need to stay in the hospital. Because if you stay in the hospital, that anything occur, it will be really difficult to help on that. So we have the criteria for the hospital cases, healthy. If you have underlying disease, need to be controlled. If you have pregnant, no, not hospital. You have to be in the hospital, something like that. Yes. Or you really elderly, more than 60 year old,With other immunity mean that you are the high risk group, go to hospital, not hospital. You have really high, really severe cough, X-ray bad, hospital, not hospital.
So we have question from Ms. Rosanna. Can we get vaccinated from vaccines from different laboratories?
Vaccination?
Like, yeah, vaccination. Like, I understand that this question may be about the cross vaccination, like the first dose from one company, the next dose from another company. If I get this wrong, please feel free to write some comments.
I am not understand the question. I'm sorry. Please repeat your question again.
คือเหมือนกับว่าวัคซีนสมมุติว่าโดสจากหนึ่งอย่างเงี้ยค่ะอย่าง AstraZeneca โดสที่สองมาจากซีโนฟาร์มอย่างเงี้ยค่ะอาจารย
์โอเค actually this one this mean that the brand name in Thailand we have two brand Sinovac and also AstraZeneca actually the question yesterday they have the discuss on this one for the expert on vaccineIf we have the Sinovac, for example, I have Sinovac, and Sinovac from China, they have two shot. The first shot and the second shot, 3 weeks. We believe that the first shot, it will help us the antibody about 50%. But after you have the second shot, the antibody will be about 80 to 90%. AstraZeneca, first shot.We also have two shot. The first shot that you have antibody very high, it is increasing very high, about 80%. Second shot about 90% something. But we have the choice that if you after you injection with Sinovac, but you have very severe adverse reaction from the vaccine, we could give them another choice for AstraZeneca.But the most common suggestion that from the clinician suggested that better have the same. So because they will remember, Sinovac, they are the dead virus. AstraZeneca, they have the mRNA virus. They just sleeping, something like that. They're not dead. So most of the report from the adverse reaction from the vaccine, we found that the...AstraZeneca have more side effect than Sinovac. Mm-hmm. Yes. But we don't have experience on Pfizer. No experience on Moderna or Johnson. Cannot answer. Next time, nah, not cannot, I'm sorry. We have data only from the Sinovac and Astra.
Next question is from Ms. Amanda.
How
is COVID-19 reinfections being managed in the face of the different variables or different strands? คือ COVID-19 reinfection การติดเชื้อ COVID-19 อีกครั้งหนึ่งอะค่ะว่าโดยเฉพาะกับพวกแอนใหม่ๆอะค่ะอย่างครั้งแรกมาเป็นสแตรนด์อังกฤษครั้งต่อไปเป็นสแตรนด์แอฟริกาแล้วเราจะจัดการลักษณะการติดใหม่แบบนี้ยังไงอะค่ะ
Okay, I think if we remember my slide, the first slide and the second slide, that coronavirus, even though they have the many variety of genome, they are doublet transmission. So the doublet transmission have this thing that we need to prevent them by using the prevention from the doublet. Cough etiquette, wear mask,Stay distancing, wash your hand awfully. In all age group, in everyone have to do same thing, wear mask, even though the surgical mask or cloth mask, because the cloth, I have surgical mask. I have the cloth mask, not this one, my cloth mask, Kitty.This one, we got this one, right? So it's easy to help the student or the how why to make it. It's really good because you can wash them. You one cloth mask you can use for maybe many time washing them. So this one, less the disposal, something like that, less the waste product. So this one that we help them and they could in some, statistic in some governor said that they can use this one to sharing the free or they can selling them or something like that because it's easy to use this. So suggest that doesn't matter for the any kind of the genome of the virus. The SARS-CoV virus, they have the same thing. They are the doublet precaution, a doublet transmission. They might have the contact transmission because of the sneezing or because of any mucus from the body. Suggestion, washing your hand oftenly, either by soap with water or alcohol gel with 75%. Nah? Because if less than that, the virus not die. To make sure that the virus of the coronavirus easy to die, because they are enveloped virus. The envelope made from, they are made from the fat cover on the envelope. So to be strongly recommend that washing your hand and washing every common area. For example, the door. เรียกว่าอะไรเนาะไอ้ที่เปิดประตูเรียกว่าอะไรนะ
ลูกปิดประตู door knob
knob อะ or the stair or in the elevator or elevator. So in the hospital or any the public area, they need to more often to clean them. They will die easily. Even though with soap and water, they die. So this one is, if we know their nature, people, somebody using the bank, somebody say that they are afraid of bank, you know, bank, the money. They, after they touch the money, they wash their hand. Okay, no problem. Don't touch your eye. Don't touch your nose if you did not wash your hand. Mm-hmm. Yes.
The next yes. question.
Hay otra pregunta.
Is there any question from the floor?
There's another question.
Yes, please.
Yes,
yeah.
please.
Sí.
Hay otra pregunta.
Okay, there's another question with regard to medical staff. So they're asking, what have the cases of death or infections been like amongst first-line responder, medical responders, and how often have reinfections been common after being vaccinated?
Okay, for the healthcare worker, may I show you the slide? Actually, I have another slide for the healthcare worker. Nah, shall I show you that one? Excuse me.
Let's see.
Can I show you on the slide of the this one? I will share my slide better because it's more clear. The more share my slide, nah.
Okay.
Okay, that's fine.
Did you see my slide? เห็นไหมคะ
Yes, we can see it.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes,
I will show you the bigger one. I will show you the bigger one. This one is a personal protective, not productive. No, protective. Protective. Protective equipment. Okay. This slide, it.This one say that personal protective equipment for health personnel. We using this one for many health professional, from the nurse, health professional, from the ID doctor, from the Department of Disease Control, from the FDA, from the CHESS Institute, something like that. You could download from this one, actually in Thai. Actually, this one I have the video. I think Thaika, we could share you with that.The my video or on the how we using that one, we conclude in four step. The first one, we divided the list of the healthcare worker in four level. Low list, I'm sorry, it's in Thai. Nah, it will be in English later. Nah, healthcare worker who are the healthcare worker. This one that you need to wear the for healthcare worker for the low list. For example, the personnel who do the screening, the personnel who do take care of the patient when they cannot walk using the wheel, right? And also the healthcare personnel that who the like the public relation at the in front of the hospital, they will wear face shield, even hair cover. Yes or no? No, no need. They wear the goggle or face shield.Some if they have the discard at the patient, the healthcare worker who using the thermal scan, what is the your temperature, they will wear the face shield, they will say surgical mask, that's it. But for the one who take care of the patient, for example, the bed or the view, they will wear more. They might wear more on the protective gown. For the moderate risk, this one, most of the healthcare worker are the clinician, the doctor, the nurse, or the pharmacy, they will wear this one. The X-ray patient, the X-ray healthcare worker, they have to wear the cover gown, isolation gown, face shield, surgical mask, and also they might have to cover or not, maybe not. But this one very important, and they need to wear the glove moderately. And also if they were working with the like the janitor or something like that, or who are working for take the dirty clothes from the AI clinic, because after the doctor or nurse or the healthcare worker take off their clothes, the one who the cleaner have to wear like this full PPE with the what we call with the glove, special glove, and also wear the N95. This one that did you see, they wear N95, they wear the eyeglass, face shield to protect them, also with the boot or shoe cover on this one to protect them from the contact and droplet transmission. This one same, the model is this. All healthcare worker training by ICN. The ICN will training the ICWN. ICWN is mean that infection control nurse ward. They will have to learn and training everyone, maybe once a week or maybe oftenly, and observe, do they do the colleague or not? Because if not, they will have the infected. And high risk group, mostly the doctor who do the nasopharyngeal swab, the dentist, and also the laboratory person who work with the swab, this one, or work from the lab, they need to wear cover gown to cover N95, goggle, face shield, this one, and also the cough, doctor also wear this. And the really high risk, this means that mostly the doctor who work with the bronchoscope, intubation, CPR, ICU, or for medical care for a long time, they need to wear the hair cover, goggle, or face shield, plus face shield. They wear N95, N99, P100, or PAPR if they have. In Thailand, we run out of N95. The thing that we use, we have to reuse. This is the problem, but for now, we have more N95, so it helps us a lot. And however, N95, if you wear correctly, you cannot wear more than 30 minutes because you have to do the face check and face fit check and face check or standard that one. So we suggest the one who stay in the bronchoscope, intubation, or ER, we suggest doctor, the nurse wear PAPR and cover all on that one. So this one just the thing that we need to share with the nurse, I think. Okay, this one as this one PAPR, no? It's really important. And when the doctor, if we have, we want have many, some case of the COVID-19, they we need to do the ECMO or hemodialysis, something like that. The doctor and the nurse have to wear PAPR because they may stay a long time, one more than 1 hour. So it really helpful on that. I think that's all for the sharing of the PPE. Yes.
So we have another question about the experience of the use of hydroxychloroquine, ค่ะ อาจารย
์ ว่า
คือHas Thailand has been using this medical this medication, and what is the experience of Thailand using this medication?
Yes, for the hydroxychloroquine, right?
Okay.
Hydroxychloroquine. In Thailand, in beginning, we have using the hydroxychloroquine or chloroquine as the combination drug, not only one drug. Because hydroxychloroquine and, if you remember my picture in the beginning, we found that the hydroxychloroquine, I can find, hydroxychloroquine and hydroxychloroquine that using, they will stop the, when the cell, virus cell come into the human cell, they will replicate. Hydroxychloroquine will inhibit the replicate of the virus. However, for this one that we found that they have the side effect. The side effect of hydroxychloroquine mostly come with the nausea, vomiting, and they also have the drug interaction with the other antiviral. They, especially for the lopinavir, ritonavir, we found the patient have the QT prolonged. So if we cannot detect the QT prolonged, patient might die from cardiac standstill or cardiac arrest. So also we have many studies suggest that when compared with other, so we stop using the hydroxychloroquine and chloroquine. No more for now, nah? Yes. Do I answer Ajahn Kwan Pong Jan Tam with my?
Sí.
Yes, any question, please.
Por favor, hay una pregunta sobre vacunas.
Elena.
The next question is the infection and also the time of, I think that the herd community in Thailand, whether or not we have reinfection of patients and what is our plan about, having the herd community in Thailand?
For the herd community in Thailand, we believe that for the COVID-19, herd community is really difficult because of what? Because they have many genomes. Like in Thailand, we have like the influenza or common cold. It's not like the measles. The measles, they have only one genome. So it's easy to eradication. The WHO means need to be eradication because they have only one. The virus is cannot replicate or change awfully like the COVID. COVID-19 is really clever. Clever than influenza, somebody said that. Because when we give medication, now we study for the drug resistance. We believe that the favipiravir is not the drug of choice of COVID-19. Favipiravir is only the broad spectrum of the viral and antiviral. So it is, we found that in the laboratory, they study that the virus, when they faced with the virus, with antiviral, they will have mutation to survive. Similar to the HIV. You will know that HIV is also RNA virus, and they will have the mutation awfully. So we found that the AIDS patient have the drug resistance. COVID-19 is also the same thing. So to answer the herd immunity, I think herd immunity of the COVID-19 for now, for today, cannot say that we will have herd immunity, but in the future, maybe yes. We need to study more and learn more on that one. Just for now, I cannot say we have herd immunity. In the future, maybe yes, nah? We waiting, we hopefully. Yes, please.
The next question is, what beliefs of the population of Thailand may have made it difficult to treat people with COVID-19? What beliefs of ความเชื่อของคนไทยอะไรที่ทำให้แบบการรักษาโควิด -19 มันยากอะไรอย่างเงี้ยค่ะ
Okay, as we say that Thailand have the governments and also the Ministry of Public Health have also the say that all cases that who have the fever, have the COVID-19 need to admit, because from the cases, from the study, we found that the day 5, after the patient have infected, the virus will replicate. If the patient strong, the white blood cell will kill the virus. They might have some fever, okay, sneezing, that's it, no more. We call them asymptomatic. Or really my symptom. But if that patient have not strong enough, they might have the virus. The viper cell cannot kill virus. The virus will go to the pneumonia, have developed pneumonia. We found that most of the cases in the Asia type have the fever or pneumonia at the day 5 to day 7. So from the CPT national guideline, we admit the patient at least 7 days before we move them to the hospital or we move them to the field hospital. But for the new type B1.1.7, it's very severe. We found that they develop the pneumonia at the day 10, not day 5, day 10. So it's very important that because from the study, also from the review, we found that similar to Thailand, similar to the many study that the patient have, we call happy pneumonia, happy hypoxia. What does it mean? This means that oxygen set is very important because when the patient admit, we lost some patient, we call drop dead. Then we discuss with us and they go, you are really happy, nah? You go home. After the day, after that, drop dead happened. So this one remind our clinician for now that after the patient admit or you discharge the patient, you have to be sure that oxygen set of the patient need to be more than 96 or near normal. This means that at the room air, say 97 something. If the oxygen set of the patient when they arrive, because we found the patient from the discard among the case, from case conference or death conference, we found that there are one man, 50 years old, 55 years old. They come with the day 5. They okay, they go home. Okay, because we have not enough bed. Okay, you stay home. We following them. The day 7, they come to the hospital and they feel not good for breathing. After that, on checking the oxygen set, oxygen set about the 90%. We give them the cannula, oxygen cannula. It's still 91%. This means that not good. So we admit. After admit, before admit, we do X-ray. Only the infiltration at the lower lung. 4 hours later, he become the ARDS. It's really rapidly or progressive. So this means that this make us and also the clinician to aware that if the patient we admit, we need to monitoring for the oxygen set. If they have the risk factor, uncontrolled DM, obesity, other chronic disease, oxygen set may be monitored every 2 hours to make sure that they are safe. Otherwise, it will become rapidly to become the, we call them the happy hypoxia.
Sí, okay. La pregunta se refiere también, por lo que entendemos, si hay creencia.
From what we understand, I think the question also has to do with are there many beliefs of a religious type or some other belief that have made treatment difficult?
The treatment among the religious, you mean?
Sí. Well, si se refiere a creencias religiosas.
I mean, any kind of beliefs, like religious beliefs, maybe?
I think for the religious belief, we not found the problem yet for the treatment. Nah. Because most of them, I think, type, they are afraid of the COVID. If they have fever and that one, they come, a lot of people come to the check up for the swab, something like that. The religious, we not found that problem now, not yet.
I think that at this stage we have more people coming for you know a swab and also you know volunteer for increasing number for volunteer for vaccination as well. So we haven't really got any problem with the belief so far, but we might actually have some ceremonies that might actually infect you know have some effects on having too many people gathering at the same time, like the last Thai New Year Songkran festival, which a lot of people gathered, and you know the spread happened during that time.
So yes.
So we also have another question. In the case of Peru, there has been an increase of in death of the young adult population คือมีจำนวนคนเสียชีวิตที่เป็นคนเป็นคนวัยหนุ่มสาวอะค่ะอาจารย์ In Thailand how the virus has behaved with respect to its young adult population do we have like increasing numbers of
yes we do yes we do let me find the slide about the date okay yes we do have the youngest of the dead case about the in the teenager in the children not found yet about the 19 or 20 years old that we found they have the underlying disease they have the about the leukemia something like the about the blood problem we found that one and most of the case dead for now that the factor that are the underlying disease or cancer also they are dead also many case we have two healthcare worker dead from the COVID the first doctor is he work in the private clinic he's very kind man so I mean very kind to take to treat the patient he is about 65 years old he have the underlying the cancer and also when after infected he have the ARDS and then we lost him and the second doctor also have the underlying disease are the cancer also he is the dentist other only the two healthcare worker ค่ะ
So what are the criteria for the definition of reinfection in Thailand?
Reinfection that if we have the, but in Thailand we don't have yet na. The reinfection that if the patient already infected with the COVID-19 and after treatment, they go home, they become another infected with also the different genome. This means that they have the reinfection. But if they come back within one month, something like that. And we do the swab and we found that if they still have the RT-PCR, we will look at the cycle time, something like that, yes. And we will check for the genotype. Most of them are the same. So this means that they are not reinfected. Mm. Yes.
So do another question from Ms. Helen. Do we recommend mouthwash? For dental treatments and do they prevent COVID-19 ใช้พวกน้ำยาบ้วนปากค่ะอาจารย์หรือว่าเรื่องเกี่ยวกับแบบพวกฟันอะไรอย่างเงี้ยค่ะ
ค่ะ for the dentist they have the protocol if you interested in we will find out for the dentist association if you want we will share with the Taika and share with you on that one because we have the step from the reading the doctor if you are want to do the dentist during the outbreak the dentist no we not doing any dentist except you have the emergency of the dentist or dental problem mm. we just treat them for example you have the broken of teeth or anything or have the emergency for the teeth for the doctor dental นะ this one they will treat if not they won't treat for example if they have many aerosol See, for example the เรียกว่าอะไรวะที่มันกรอฟันเยอะๆเขาเรียกภาษาอังกฤษเขาเรียกว่าอะไร I don't know what they call in English I just know that explain that if you go to see the doctor the dentist will do the your mouth and with, they will have the protect อะไรนะเขาเรียกว่าอะไรล้างหินขุดหินปูนเรียกว่าอะไรขุดหินปูนอะ
plague get rid of the plague
yeah that one day the dentist they say that not emergency no need to do because they have too many aerosolBefore they do anything with the patient, they will let the patient special mouthwash for one minute. For put in the mouth for 1 minute to make sure that no more problem.
So what is the percentage of asymptomatic infected persons?
60% in Thailand. 60%.
60%.
Yes.
So what is your comment to use what is it? It's called chlorine dioxide.
What is it?
Chlorine dioxide. น่าจะเป็นพวกลายน้ำเกลือไหมคะอาจารย์เป็นคลอรีนแบบ C H
I'm not sure เขาถามอะไรไม่เข้าใจคำถาม
เป็นใช้คลอรีนไดออกไซด์อะค่ะ
For what for the dentist you mean or for whom
อันนี้เป็น another question เป็นคำถามใหม่นะคะอาจารย
์new question I cannot answer for now I'm do apologize do you mind if the Thai guy help me to written the question and we will answer to you later
ได้ค่ะเดี๋ยว
I'm sorry for this one I cannot answer for this question I do apologize
is a chlorine dioxide นะคะเป็นสารฆ่าเชื้อค่ะอาจารย์ตามเข้าใจว่ามันคล้ายๆกับเบตาดีนเนี่ยแหละค่ะสีเหลืองอมเขียวลักษณะไม่ละลายน้ำกระจายตัวของเหลวในสถานการณ์อะไรนะก๊าซละลายได้
ดังนั้นไม่เป็นไรค่ะเก็บคำถามไว้ก่อนหมอไม่ตอบไม่ได้ค่ะขอโทษด้วย I'm sorry นะ I will write you, I take note your question I will answer to you later I will ask the expert I cannot answer I'm sorry
ค่ะOkay, so the next question is from Mr. Fernando. In an asymptomatic healthcare worker who have contact with COVID patients and have negative antigenic test, is it necessary to take a PCR test to confirm first result?
Okay, very good question. In Thailand, we face this problem, antigen test. Antigen said in Thailand that we believe from the study we found that antigen test could believe only 30%.That mean that they have false negative and false positive. Mean that if you are positive, doesn't mean you are positive. If you are negative, you might be positive. So we not count on antigen test or antibody test. Even though it's very fast, but it make us confusing. So the gold standard is the RT-PCR only. In Thailand, we do the very fast for the RT-PCR 4 hours.Oh, how about Peru? How many hours that you using for the RT-PCR? Ask back. I ask you.
Apsi, can you help with that question or in SAP, please?
Would you mind repeating that question, please?
Okay, my question is that what is the gold standard for diagnosis for the COVID-19 in your country? In Thailand, we're using RT-PCR, not antigen or antibody test.
Si, por favor, si pudieran responderlo, señores del
ministro. Yes, if people from the Ministry of Health, could you please respond? What is the most used test here?
Prueba molecular, prueba antigénica COVID.
We use the antigen, the molecular test and the antigen test.
ใช้ antigen test ค่ะอาจารย์แสดงว่าเขาไม่ได้ใช้ RT-PCR เหมือนเรา
Okay, because in Thailand we found very big problem of antigen test. When they do antigen test, if they are negative, but when we do RT-PCR, they are positive.They could spread the disease to other because they are, oh, I'm free, no disease, but actually they do. So that's our problem in Thailand. So we not count on antigen tests, except the patient that have really severe pneumonia and we need to give them the medication. They are already in our hospital. We send the RT-PCR. It might take two more hours. So we just test, if antigen test positive, we give them directly for that.Medication but we also still need waiting for the RT-PCR another 2 hours to make sure that they we are go the right track not the wrong track on that
actually just
una pregunta más para pasar ya a la parte final
one more question so before
yes please go ahead please
sorry just so we can go on to the next section please one more question if I could just issue an opinion on what you're asking. Go ahead. What?
Okay. So is there any question from the floor?
So, with S.
No more. Continue, por favor.
Actually, we have a few more questions from the chat room.
It's a gentleman asking a question. Sorry, he's trying to speak, but he's not sure if he can speak. I think he's
yes,
hesitant.
Please do.
What I wanted to ask was that.
Yes.
Sorry, Dr. Naramo. What I wanted to say is that I think there's a clinical criterion that needs to be taken into consideration. So if a patient has a high respiratory criterion, then we assume it's COVID. And the test, like Dr. Naramo said, we don't assume that the test is helping all that much. All the more so on the second phase when the patient is already having respiratory difficulty. A CT scan is actually more helpful in those cases. But I'm talking about a tertiary hospital. Obviously, that presents a difficulty in other places. But I would say that the CT scan at this stage would be our gold standard. But the other tests don't really help us all that much at the lower clinical level. I mean, we assume what the government is telling us, right? Whether or not you have, everybody's just isolated and we all fulfill what's being said officially there. Everybody has to be isolated. And then if you get positive or negative tests, nonetheless, you still have to be isolated and protect those. Thank you.
So, okay. In Thailand, we're using the oxygen set and XLA because we don't have enough the CT scan. CT scan mostly are in Bangkok. In the outside Bangkok, we have the, as I told you, we have the 77 province. Most of the CT scan will be only in the big hospital, but we have the cases of Thailand. The thing that we recommend for the doctor that you're using the oxygen set, using the three, using the physical exam of the, also the using the X-ray. X-ray is really helpful for us to see that one. Sometimes CT scan, it take about a longer time. And if the patient longer time, they are put in the CT scan maybe 10 minutes or 15 minutes. X-ray only 1 minute. So it helps us to take care of the patient. We found that oxygen set is easier to measure. Less than 1 minute, we found that, okay, you have problem. We can treat them or you can help them on that one, better than on that. So the monitoring, if the patient admit oxygen set, X-ray, the first day that you admit X-ray, chest X-ray. And following, if the oxygen set drop, we repeat X-ray, something like that. And general lab is okay. For example, CBC, UA, level function test, we also do for them on that one.
Okay.
So any more questions from the floor, Rafael?
Sí, preguntan también sobre los costos.
They're also asking on costs, like are they expensive or who covers the cost for the tests in Thailand for these tests?
Okay, in Thailand, the government, we have three. Civil servant. Second, we have the social security. And
อาจารย์ค่ะอาจารย์มิวนะคะอาจารย์อันมิวก่อนค่ะ
ขอโทษที I'm sorry in Thailand the government take care of our expense our people in Thailand we our Thai people we have three choice you four choice actually four choice the first one civil servant second social security the third one universal เรียกว่าอะไรนะ30บาทเรียกว่าอะไรว
ะ universal health coverage ค่ะอาจารย
์โอเค thank you universal health coverage but if you don't have anything insurance you might have for the foreigner in Thailand we still pay for them นะ if they don't have insurance but if the foreigner could help they will but pay by insurance and all Thai people will free of charge to treatment on thatAlso for the swab also. But swab is on nasopharyngeal swab, RT-PCR. The government will cover only you have the, during the active case finding or you are the high risk contact. If you are healthy, but you are afraid, oh, I am infected or not, but you have any history, you have to pay because you are not in the patient under investigation. To answer your question.
Muchas gracias. Cerramos entonces el bloque de preguntas. Creo que podemos pasar. No,
no, thank you very much. I think we closed the round of questions with this and we can go on to the next section.
Sure. ถามเขาไหมอยากรู้ว่าเป็นคนไงบ้างเนี่ยถามได้ไหมเนี่ย
ได้อาจารย์
thank you very much.
Yeah, Mr. Rafael, can Dr. Narimon ask some questions because perhaps if we can share some experience, it would be quite useful for the next session as well.
Thank you. My question, actually, I would like to get feedback from you that this one, that we are sharing experience from Thailand. Is it possible that you sharing your experience to us? Because we have some medical doctor and medical staff that we can learn and we can share for this one. They might share with other. They have pharmacy. We have the emergency physician in our group in the online on this one. So we can learn to it together. However, for the critical care, for now, I think for today, he cannot join us, but in the future, we can share together also on that. Yes, please. In the beginning, I heard that you talking about
it. Yes, entre nosotros, participantes.
Well, amongst us, we have participants from the various subsectors of health in the country. We have participants from the social insurance, from the Ministry of Health, and also from the various regions, from the regional governments. So what is being requested of us, dear colleagues, is if from your points of view, both in hospitalizing COVID patients, as well as with experiences with first level care, if we could maybe briefly narrate some of our stories. I would like to invite our colleagues to please register so that we can participate.
Adelante.
Go on, please.
Bueno, mi nombre es Ada Pastor, trabajo para la Escuela Nacional.
Well, my name is Ada Pastor. I work for the National School for Public Health, and I'm going to describe Dr. Narimon very briefly how our healthcare system is organized in Peru. It is organized on the caregiving side, and it's got the financial aspect, the part that finances healthcare services and the directing body. So the directing body is the Ministry of Health. And it shares this with all regional governments and also with its subsectors. And one important subsector that encompasses almost the totality of 33 million citizens that we have in Peru, we are protected by Social Security. Is basically, it's about 12 million citizens being covered by that. And the difference of that is shared by the Comprehensive Health Insurance Service that absorbs 15 million citizens. Then we also have an important citizen with the police forces that have their own system and all other providers in the armed forces.
Yes.
Okay. En este momento,
then, so at the moment, for this presentation, we have 274 participants from all those various contexts and spaces. So we are inviting them to tell their experiences and they can participate. We, for example, we see that we have Dr. Cesar Liendo. I don't know if he would like to participate, maybe tell his experience in the social insurance. And then we also have the epidemiology department of the Ministry of Health, Dr. Uchuya, who could, and we also have other participants from the various regions that who are being invited to participate. There are also some questions in the chat if you could also take those into consideration. Hi, doctor. Good morning. My name is Waldo. I work emergency at Rebaliati Hospital. I could share an experience. my experience, one important experience has to do with communications. Communication.
La comunicación.
Communication on the evolution of patients on the day-to-day is an urgent need, not just for to avoid further contamination, but also to put the family's mind at ease. In this case, the emergency, there was a team of communicators formed through phones to call all relatives of the patients day-to-day and to carry out the necessary control of evolution of patients daily by calling the phones that they had registered. So we assembled a team so that physicians who live near the hospital would be in charge of this work. Subsequently, this work was expanded further, and older physicians or physicians who had some sort of pathology that would keep them from being part of real-time participation in emergencies, and they would also participate through communications, through over-the-phone medical communications daily. So we had a team that was more specialized, more advanced, and on the day-to-day, they would communicate with the families and communicate all the progress, and it has been a good experience, and also many physicians are telling us, and even myself, I participated myself, that it's not easy to communicate. Having daily briefings for the families is letting them know that a patient has died. It's painful.
Right.
It's very, very painful. And so, and then you have to just, you have to smooth it over every day. You know, you really can't tell them your patient is sick, it's sick, it's sick, they're sick, they're sick every day. So you have to find something positive to tell them. And then at the end of the day, when we see in the evolution of the patient that the patient is more and more deteriorated, where you start see renal failure, you start seeing multiple organ failure, then we already know the patient is, then we give them more aggressive information, trying to not just giving them our own technical criterion, but also giving them maybe, a religious perspective, any other alternatives to try to get the family to comfort it. And it's really, these information teams are necessary. And at the global level, I know that in many places and it's good to disseminate this practice. And I'm just sharing this experience with you folks. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much for your experience. It's really good to learn together. I believe that it's really painful because the patient died, the patient expired, that we try to do our best, but they're relative. And now we try to think that because of the COVID-19 is contagious. So when the patient, they suffer, they, in Thailand, are Buddhist, no? They cannot contact with other when they expire, so they have to go alone, something like that. The more severe, the more suffer something. So we just believe that early detection, early diagnosis, early treatment it will be the most thing helpful for the patient. I'm not sure that you found the happy hypoxia or not in Thailand. Now we're getting more, we found that. The patient smiling, okay, I'm happy, but oxygen said 85, something like that. It's well, getting more alert for the doctor. If you saw the patient, don't think that they are okay. You should measure for oxygen set and also exhale them after they see you the first day. Yes. Thank you.
Por favor, si fuera posible que el doctor Eliseo
Apaza. If it's possible for Dr. Eliseo Apaza to please comment what he has placed in the chat, if he could just tell us. Dr. Apaza, yes, if you would be so kind. He says he has no microphone.
Sí, por favor. Gracias.
Okay, this is the interpreter. I'm going to read that to you because the gentleman has no microphone. He says, Dr. Eliseo says, I suggest that all the various levels of care need to be interconnected because when a physician at first level transfers a patient to a hospital, you lose all communication on the case. And then the physician at the hospital doesn't have that information when treating the patient. So that there needs to be greater communication when switching levels.
In Japan, we're using the telemedicine also. Do you using telemedicine? Yes. เขาใช้ป่ะ ดามปิดไหม ไม่ได้ยิน
I don't know if you understood the question. So he was basically saying that there's, do you have different tiers of care? And as you go from tier one to tier two to tier three, you lose information. So the hospital physician doesn't get the information that the first treating physician had. Well, Ada says, yeah, so the question has been translated. So you get difficulties that we encounter in our country with coordination and communication between the professionals who are at what we call first level of care, which supposedly we look at cases from the start. And then when these are evolved and need to be transferred to a big hospital, all communication on the history of the patient is lost, and you lose that connection that there should be between the physician that is close to the home and the physician working at the hospital. So, and I understand that the doctor's answer is the use of telemedicine to counter that. Not just physician to patient, but physician to physician. Is that your answer, Dr. Ram?
Yes. Because in Thailand, when we now, we have to do the communication. The government say that 90% work from home, except the hospital. So the thing that if we share experience of some part of that, to prevent infection among us. So the thing that, because we don't know, our good friend is might have infected. So the thing that we using the telemedicine among the doctor, telemedicine among the, during the meeting, something like that, to keep distancing among each other. But among the telemedicine, among the doctor and patient or nursing and patient, they will say hi every day. So it might using, I'm not sure in Peru, using LINE or WhatsApp or something like that. That one that we could communicate with them and we could see face each other. So we can check that they are okay or not from this cut with us, something like that, yes. Telepharmacy also is very important. I think my pharmacy team is still here. We're using the telepharmacy. As I tell in the beginning that we're using deliver by using the post-test deliver medication to the patient. But they will like, okay, this is my home address, send me and I pay you the money by banking, transferring, something like that. Yes.
We are using that, but not in all places due to the differences in the communication system. Our question is really more linked to difficulties that are inherent in our country. So the question is, how would you identify and register patients in Thailand, both testing results for COVID testing results, and a very specific question is if you in Thailand have a unified digital patient history system, and how have you managed to get this unified clinical history system so that it can be seen in various stages of care, first, second, or third care, or the various subsystems? And the question obviously is, how do we get to that?
Answer your question. As I told you that we have primary, secondary, tertiary, and super tertiary. Mostly of the primary case, we using the, we have communicate. We set up the national level consultation. And also we have the regional consultation. If the doctor from the primary hospital, I have problem, I'm not sure this kind of case need to give the medication, or if you see the chest X-ray, is it COVID or other bacterial infection or not, they will take the photo and send to the, by communicate. We're using LINE, in Thai we're using LINE and email. We're not using a lot of WhatsApp, but we're using LINE application, email. They will send and then call. Okay, I send you the information. What do you think? What do we have to do? If okay, oxygen set, not good. X-ray, getting worse, we within 6 hours, I will refer to you. Okay. If the we have the referral as the ranking, primary to secondary to tertiary and super tertiary, something like that. So they communicate this, and also they have the referral form. They call referral form. The doctor, the first doctor will lighting up. What is the name of patient? What is their ship complaint? What are their physical exam? What is the laboratory important lab? I do the PCR, but not get the result. I have the coding. We call set code. Set code is mean the situation awareness. Situation. They be coding. In the beginning, we using the one who give the set code from the lab and from the epidemiologist, they give the lab and ICN in the hospital. And we, because we don't want they to know the name. After that, we have the problem because they're missing among the set code. So now we change, we using the 13 digit. In Thailand, we call 13 digit. This means that identification number. Everyone in Thailand, they have only one ID. 13 digit on that one, we're using that. But some hospitals still using the set code, we call that one. So when they send in this one, they will, the doctor from hospital A send to the hospital B. They will ask, okay, what, who is this person? What is the laboratory result? So not only the history of the patient, go with the patient, we call referral form. The set code will go directly to that hospital later. They will have ICN, is the key person who following the laboratory result. Yes.
Muchas gracias. Para indicarles también de que estaremos...
Thank you very much. And also let you know that we'll be closing soon. We will organize another event where we will share the Peruvian experience with our friends from Thailand. And it will be a series of seminars that will be webinars that we will arrange. We'd like to thank you. And Pam, I'd like, you can say a few words if you would like to.
All right.
Continue.
I say some few words that all information, not today, today we just start. I think in the future you can communicate with us either by Taika or by with me from the email. So she will happy to chat with you and we could help together to combat with the global or pandemic COVID-19. We go to help to each other, fighting together.
Thank you very much. So that was a very fruitful discussion and I was really impressed by how you guys are so attentive in this webinar.
Haremos llegar de todas maneras las preguntas.
That was a really...
We will send you the questions nonetheless. We'll make sure those questions get to you anyway.
Okay.
Sabemos que por cuestiones de tiempo y...
Sorry that due to time constraints, I know that it's almost midnight for you folks over there. So we are so very thankful for the time difference too. And nonetheless, I know that there are many questions and concerns that there was no time for. But we'll make sure that everyone's questions reach the other side, and we will be organizing the next meeting so that we can share more experiences.
That is amazing.
Gracias.
I have collected some of the issues and I believe that we could share the issues later. Rafael, you have my contact and we could exchange our contacts later and do some other amazing webinars in the future. Thank you so much for today.
Thank you so much. Hope to see you later.
And on our end, we would also like to thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you, Doctor, for the seminar. Thank you to the entire Apps team. Very, very grateful. And there will be another opportunity to greet you once again. Thank you very much.
Gracias.
Thank you. Gracias.
Bye-bye.
Gracias.
Thank you.
Bye bye.
Gracias.
Gracias. Gracias.